Good morning. Good morning from the Tabernacle of David Prophetic Dance Center in Jerusalem. It's a glorious day because I woke up today, and there are endless possibilities in this day in Yeshua's name. Amen. Well, I want to encourage you today to just put one foot in front of the other and breathe in and breathe out and keep your thoughts where your feet are. Try to stay in the present. You know, sometimes we can get very caught up with life, but there's been many times that I've noticed when I've slowed down and I've looked around and I wanted to engage in relationships. I have relationships, but what I've noticed is that there's many people that are so caught up with their own lives that they're not emotionally available. And once upon a time, I was not. I was living my life on automatic pilot before I knew the Lord Yeshua. And there was a time when I really thought my feelings would kill me because I had been through so much trauma as in my early childhood, in my infancy years. And as I grew up, I realized that I thought my feelings would kill me. And I was able to get brave enough with the Lord to start facing my feelings and talking about my feelings. And I like to say that I'm an advocate of the heart. I've talked a lot lately about the imbalance of children of God. You know, we go to communities, we worship, we want to get high on the Spirit, you know, we're filled with the Spirit. But in our humanity, in our unresolved issues, we are still broken and unresolved in those areas. And God saved us, and He wants to clean us up. Because the more healing we have, the more effective we can be for the kingdom of God. And so I don't want to be one of those people who's been walking with the Lord for 50 years and is still broken. And I don't mean, as the Bible says, to be broken bread and poured out wine. That's a positive thing, to be so available, to be so vulnerable before the Lord and to other people, to be so ready to help and transparent. Broken bread and poured out wine, I don't mean that, because that's positive. I mean brokenhearted, where we've never stopped to pick up the pieces with the Lord. We need to get balanced. We really, really do. From my life, it's not acceptable to remain broken in a negative way. And so I've been on a healing path. And it's good to get around people who are like-minded, like-spirited. I've been talking lately about how I feel that the road is narrowing and that we need to live circumspectly before the Lord. What are we doing? Who are we with? Who are we spending time with? What is our intention? What is the next thing that I'm doing? It's like we really need to live step by step by step with the Lord. And I love the scripture where Yeshua says, I only do what I see my Father doing. Let's get rid of a lot of unnecessary stuff, codependency, where we're doing things because we think we should. That is emotionally not healthy. We need to be doing things led of the Spirit of God, to be motivated by the Spirit of God only. We're in difficult times now, and the challenging thing is to keep our eyes on heaven, where the world wants to pull us into conversations about all that's wrong with the world. There's a lot wrong with the world. But how can we remain a light to others who don't yet know the Lord if we're living as someone in the world is living? And the scripture says we're in the world, but we're not of it. So the temptation is to keep our eyes on heaven and remain bringing, walking, and dancing with the hope of God so we can bring it to other people. Let's not get pulled in the conversations of this world. So the weather is cooling off in Jerusalem. It's been really beautiful. And the bugs are starting to come out because it's been a breeze, but the weather is so beautiful. I just want to bless you today from the city of the great King. Keep your eyes on the prize, Yeshua, the Messiah, the one who came and did it all. He laid down his life willingly, knowing the joy that was set before him. Let's call upon Yeshua today. God, thank you for Yeshua. Thank you that you sent him. to be my kippurah, my covering, my sin offering. And when I receive him as Lord and Savior, the promised Jewish Mashiach, Messiah, the Anointed One, my slate has been cleaned. I can start again. My sins have been forgiven. And I've been washed in the blood of Yeshua. And now I can truly come into my destiny, my one-of-a-kind destiny. God bless you, Sukkot Sameach. We are commanded to rejoice in this feast of the Lord. God bless you. And you know, they say that this actually was the time of year that Yeshua was born. We have so much to celebrate today. Let's celebrate the risen King. God bless you from the city of the great King, Yerushalayim.